China's stealth fighter, the J-20 Mighty Dragon, is not anything to lose a lot of sleep over. That's according to General Kenneth Wilsbach, commander of the Pacific Air Forces Command. And his confidence comes from the fact that the radar signature of the F-22 Raptor is significantly lower than that of the J-20, and its maneuverability and air-to-air records are unmatched to this day. But why the importance of this Chinese fighter jet should not be downplayed, and how it might in fact have some advantages over the Raptor. Why the Russian engine that was initially used on the J-20 made the aircraft less stealthy. And how not having a gun helped the mission of the Mighty Dragon is not what you think. Since its first flight in 2011, the J-20 has taken the world aback by surprise, because China's answer to the American-built F-22 Raptor is the first non-American stealth fighter to be mass-produced in hundreds. When you look closely at the J-20, you see a little bit of the F-22, a little bit of the F-35, and even some resemblance to the now-abandoned Mikoyan Project 1.44, with its Canner Delta Wing design. That's because to build the Mighty Dragon, the big swath of technology needed may have in fact come from some of these very airplanes. China has a long history of technological theft, acquiring advanced military technology by procuring small quantities of foreign weapons and reverse engineering them, or using hackers if that doesn't work. While officially denying involvement, the Chinese government is known to have orchestrated several systematic technological theft attempts against American defense contractors and its allies, while attempting to access data related to the F-22 and F-35 in the process. This, combined with other espionage attempts, indigenous Chinese research, plus the remains salvaged from the F-117 crash back in 1999, is likely to have provided China the stealth technology it desperately needed to eventually build the J-20 we see today. Technological theft, however, doesn't mean the J-20's manufacturing record should be downplayed. As of 2024, there are already more than 200 J-20s in service, making China the only nation other than the United States to mass-produce stealth fighters. Regardless of it being stolen tech or not, China has been able to set up a capable manufacturing base for producing indigenous stealth fighters. This is in its own an impressive record, especially considering that even Russia has only produced just over 20 production models of the stealth Su-57. That said, the J-20's journey has been far from smooth. A major setback for the J-20 originated from its engines. Producing proper aircraft engines has been a problem for the Chinese aviation industry for decades, and the J-20 was no exception. The initial prototypes of the J-20 were fitted with the Russian AL-31 engines that were used on the Su-27 Flanker series. While the Russian engines were sufficient to take the J-20 to the sky, they could not deliver enough thrust to enable supercruise. That is, the J-20 could not go past Mach 1 without using afterburners. This was a major setback for the J-20, because the heat signature of the afterburners would be visible on radars, like the moon in the dead of night. This was obviously really bad for the J-20's stealth capabilities. Following years of domestic research and development, however, China was finally able to enhance the domestically built WS-10 engine. And by 2022, the J-20's Russian-built engines were switched over to a domestic version, which could deliver adequate thrust. The new WS-15 engine, which is capable of supercruise, finally solved the J-20's engine problem, putting it somewhat on par with the F-22. But what gives the Mighty Dragon an edge over the Raptor is the most expensive luxury in the world: time. The time gap between the development of these two aircraft is quite significant. The F-22 was designed in the 1990s, when virtually no nation other than the United States even owned stealth fighters. This gave the Raptor first kill opportunity, meaning that the pilot could track, identify, shoot, and kill other aircraft before they even knew the F-22 was there. This is why the Raptor would boast a 144-0 kill record against 4th-generation aircraft during combat exercises. But the thing is, the F-22 was not exactly built for an era where stealth fighters were more common, because it was the only one. And for that reason, the aircraft lacks the sensors needed to track other 5th-generation stealth aircraft, including an IRST seen on some legacy-generation aircraft. At least on its own, the F-22 doesn't seem to have a way to detect and engage equally sophisticated 5th-generation fighters, like the J-20, which diminishes the Raptor's first-kill opportunity advantage. Speaking of detecting stealth aircraft, how about finding out who is selling your personal data to potential scammers? Our sponsor, Optery, can help you battle them. You'll probably be shocked to find out that your home address, phone number, email and age, and even the names of your relatives, basically your private data, is sitting right in the open on the internet. And all I had to do was to sign up for Optery and scan the web. And within just a few minutes, it had found 112 matches on these data broker websites that I hadn't even heard of. So I opened one just to see what it found, and my name, phone number, and home address was sitting right there. Even the name of my spouse and one of my close friends was listed. I can only imagine what hackers and criminals could do if they wanted to target me. But Optery can help prevent them from taking advantage of my personal info, and it does that by removing my personal data from all these data broker websites that buy and sell my information. Optery has been awarded Editor's Choice by PCMag.com for the last 2 years in a row as the most outstanding data removal product on the market. Anyone can sign up on Optery for free to start their exposure risk scan and see which websites are storing their information. Optery even gives you detailed instructions for free on how to request data brokers to delete your data. And if you prefer to have Optery's robots send the deletion requests for you, you can upgrade to Optery's paid plans, which start at just $3.99 a month. You can get an extra 20% off any plan using my promo code THINK. On the flip side, since the J-20 was a late runner, it was able to incorporate many recent technologies, specifically those that prevailed after stealth technology became a thing. Things like sensor fusion, which is the capability to combine data from multiple sensors to provide more cohesive information, is more critical than ever. The newer F-35 largely follows this philosophy, offering a large suite of sensors, including an EOTS and a DAS that provides full coverage around the airframe. It's not a coincidence that the J-20 employs many of the same features, an EOTS, a DAS, and more. But in addition to the time gap, the J-20 also enjoys a benefit that is on the horizon, and that's numbers. The production of the F-22 ended in 2011, so the 185 airframes that exist today are it. Compare that to the J-20's robust production record, which towers over the F-22, with over 200 units as of 2023 and counting. The J-20's numerical advantage is a gap that will only grow. But why did China need to build this stealth fighter in the first place? Since its rise as a military power in the 2000s, the Chinese People's Liberation Army has pushed the doctrine of A2AD. In short, it wants to project power effectively to prevent foreign powers, namely the United States, from accessing its major bases in the West Pacific that enables them to intervene in Chinese military campaigns. To achieve this objective, China has gone a long way to expand its military capabilities, from its ever-growing naval fleet to an arsenal of anti-ship missiles. But they lacked something mighty in the air, a long-range fighter capable of striking beyond American forward bases in the West Pacific. And this is where the J-20 comes into the picture. The J-20 is huge. At 70 feet long, it's larger than any other stealth fighter built to date, and boasts a combat range of 1,200 miles, With its stealth capability and long range, the J-20 can fly beyond the first line of American defenses relatively undetected, choking off slower-moving supporting force multipliers, as well as striking command and control nodes. Even if the J-20 is stationed at bases deeper inside mainland China, it can still pose a major threat, because its long range gives greater margin for safety. Any forward bases near the coast will be prime targets. Inland bases, on the other hand, are better defended by air defense systems. In the greater scheme of things, the J-20 is a long-weighted spear in China's A2AD plan against the United States. A particular characteristic distinguishing the J-20 apart from other contemporaries comes from its apparent lack of guns. This isn't due to size, because even the much smaller F-35 variants are equipped with a gun. The J-20's lack of guns may hinder its engagement in dogfights. But the thing is, not having a gun actually helped the J-20's design purpose. Placing a gun inside an aircraft is often a costly and complex job. The gun and ammunition take up a considerable amount of space and weight. This is valuable space and weight that could otherwise be used to house heavier avionics, electronics, and above all, fuel. Not to mention that guns are virtually useless outside of dogfights. Kills during dogfights are scored at very close distances, usually under 800 feet, a scenario that stealth fighters are unlikely to find themselves in. This is why the Chinese dropped the gun entirely and repurposed that space and weight for fuel and avionics. With a longer range than the F-35s and equipped with sensors that are more technologically advanced than the F-22s, one could argue that the J-20 is in the Goldilocks zone. Said in practice, a hypothetical air battle between fifth-generation fighters will come down to the overall situation, the existence of supporting friendly units, and the skill set of the pilot. However, the capacity of an individual fighter will still remain crucial. Of course, the United States isn't a sitting duck in this game. The Pentagon is already exploring a replacement for the F-22 known as the NGAT. A sixth-generation air superiority platform highly integrated with drones and cutting-edge avionics would be a quantum leap from the F-22 and further the gap with the J-20, with just one minor caveat. It's still years away from becoming a reality. In fact, at this point, we don't even know what it looks like. So for now, the primary opponents of the J-20 will more or less be the existing same-generation F-22s and F-35s, while the J-20 remains a force that cannot simply be ignored.